So today, we'll use the grid and form component to work on contact. First, let's create a new component. So open your code editor, open components, and here, create a new file, contact.js. We'll use a functional component, so add export default function and a component name, app contact. In return, let's add a div tag with the text contact. Now, let's import this component under app.js. So on top, import app contact. Then at the bottom, add app contact element. Once done, check the site. You can see contact, it means our component is working. Now, let's add this title and a subtitle. Let's also add the container component. So open React Bootstrap, click components, layout, grid. Copy the import of container and add them under contact.js. You can now remove this div tag and instead add this section, add ID, contact, then add a class block and contact block. Inside this section, you can add the container element. Also add the fluid. For the title and subtitle, I want to add a div tag and a class title holder. For title, let's use the s2 tag. For the subtitle, add another div tag with a class subtitle. You can copy the subtitle from the actual website. You can then paste it over here. Check the side, and now you should see the title and subtitle. Now let's work on this form using the forms component. So go back to React Bootstrap, click forms, layout, and form grid. Copy the import of call, form, and row. You can add them at the very top. Then copy this form element and add them after the title holder div. In the form element, add a class contact form. Then in this call element, in small device, I want to use a grid value of 4. Let's add this full name. It has got a placeholder, enter your full name. So you can add it over here. It's just a text box. So you can add a type text. Then we need the email address. So in placeholder, add enter your email address. Then use email as a type. Then we need a contact number. So in placeholder, add enter your contact number and use till as a type. Now in another row element, we have got a text area. So add row element. inside row use col element, and in this col in small device I want to use a grid value of 12. Now for the text area, go back to React Bootstrap, click floating labels and text area. You can copy this line of code and add them over here. In the placeholder, you can say enter your message. Finally, we need a button, so let's use the button component. But first, let's add a div tag with a class btnHolder. Now go back to React Bootstrap, click Components and Buttons. Copy the import of button, add them at the very top. Now you can use the button element. The text of the button is submit. So this will have a type submit. Once done, check the side and you can see the form over here. In the actual side, we also have a form validation. This is just the HTML5 validation. If you want to add them, you can go back to your code and in each form control, just add required. Once done, check the side, click submit, and you should also have the form validation. Now let's add this Google map. So after this container element, add a div tag with the class Google map. Now here we need to put the iframe. So open the new tab, type google.com/maps. You can search any location over here. Let me search London. Click share, embed a map, and you can copy this HTML and you can paste it over here. You can then remove width, height, and the style. Once done, check the preview. And now we can see a Google map over here. If you go back to the code editor, you can see a warning message over here saying iframe must have a unique title property. So in this iframe, just add title attribute and add any name, for example map. The warning message is gone. Now let's add this contact information. So after this Google map div, add the container element. You can also add fluid. Then add a div tag with the class contact info. Then let's add UL li. For the icon, you can go back to the website. You can copy the HTML and paste it over here. Then copy the email address. Add another li. Again, for the icon, go back to the website, copy the HTML and paste it over here. You can also copy the contact number. Finally, add another ally. Copy the icon. Then copy the location. Once done, check the preview and you can see the contact information. Also, it is looking exactly the same as in the design. Great! This is the end of the session. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. Thank you.